Hello, and I'd like to talk to you about how to use the snipping tool to do a screen capture. There are other ways to do this, but the easiest way is the built-in screen tool. And I'm doing this on Windows 8. The snipping tool exists on earlier versions of Windows as well. And so the gestures in the UI might look a little different, but it's about the same. You find the snipping tool. So I'm going to hit the Windows icon, and I'm going to type the SN, and it brings up the snipping tool. And so here I go, and it's giving me this option to say snipping tool, and I'd like to say I'm going to do a new window snip. And now it's kind of graying out the screen and following me around with this little red line, and I click on this, and it has made a copy of that window. Now this is snipping tool is just the snipping tool. That window still exists, but this is now, oh, I didn't want to do that. This is now just a drawing tool that's so here you are. We could save this, but the other thing you can do, and this is in the more recent snipping tools, is you can make changes. So let's say, for example, you didn't want to show your name, and your name was in this path, and so I will just go and scribble my name out, like with this little scribbling tool. Pretty sweet, huh? So there I scribbled my name out. I just happened to have my name in it, so I just didn't want to put it in. So now I'm going to do File, Save As. And of course, find somewhere. I'm going to put this on my desktop, and I'm going to call it notepad.png. Now, you don't have to put the suffix of .png or JPEG, but it's good if you're moving files between systems to put these suffixes on. Windows would know this was a PNG file, but .png is a way to nicely tell other systems when you're moving it around. It's a PNG file, or if you send it as an email or whatever. So I save it. I'm saving it on my desktop. And there we go. So it's hiding the .png, but I can look to make sure the PNG is really there. And so there it is. It's a .png. And so there's a file, and away we go. Okay? So there's the snipping tool. If I close this window and I click on Notepad, you will see that it's got the little scribbling thing. Thank you for that. Okay, so there you go. That's how to do a real simple snipping tool.